My name is Mrs. Artie the Party Clown, and guess what? I'm here today to let you know about one of the things in the art room. That is this contraption behind me called the drying rack. Well, I want to teach you today how to use it. And it's really not that complicated, but if you do it the wrong way, then you can ruin a lot of artwork, and that would be really sad for other people in your art class. So, let's get started with this drying rack thing. So here it is. The shelves on the drying rack go up and down, and up and down, and up and down. If you want to use this correctly, most people think you just take a piece of artwork and slide it in. Doesn't work very well. So I'm going to show you the right way to do it. If you have a piece of artwork, you're going to lift up the shelves. You take your piece of artwork and put it on the lowest shelf that you can. Then you take the shelf above it and pull it down. After you do that, you can take, you know, the next person behind you can take their artwork and let it down. And then pulled out another shelf. It's as easy as that. Now, while there is artwork on there, you do not want to take shelves and lift them up like this. If you do, stuff just starts falling out in the back, and that ain't good. So, be sure you keep, I gotta pull this back up. Be sure that you never lift up shelves that already have artwork on them. And you start at the lowest shelf you can, and pull down shelves on top of it. Also, it's good to know what you need to put on the art drying rack. You do not need to put artwork that is dry. So if it just has pencil or color pencil or marker on it, you don't need to put it on the drying rack. You do need to put artwork that has wet stuff on it, like glue or glitter. Ooh, glitter. Or paint. Those are the things that make artwork wet, and it needs to be on the drying rack so that it doesn't mess up somebody else's artwork and it doesn't mess up your artwork. So that's all for today, my friends. Thank you for listening.